Have you ever wanted to make a movie? Like, make your own movie. Your story on the screen. That was my biggest dream as a kid, but I had a problem. No one I knew was interested in making movies with me. I could usually convince a sibling or two, or classmates if it was for school, but for the most part, I was on my own. For the writing, the filming, the editing, alone. Did I let that stop me? Absolutely not. Hey guys, welcome back to my channel, or welcome if you're new. I am really, really excited about today's video. I have been planning this one for a long time, and it is all about making your own movie. And when I say that, I know there's lots of other videos out there about how to make your own short film, how to make a movie, but today I'm actually going to be going over something really specific. It's how to make a movie by yourself with no crew, just you. In the future, I'm going to be making more videos that expand further on every single area that we go over today. So if that's something that interests you, then consider subscribing so you won't miss a thing. I've been making my own movies for well over a decade, closer to 20 years actually, ever since I got my hands on a camera when I was a young kid. Nothing is holding you back from creating your vision but you. So if you want to learn how you can do it all on your own, then stay tuned. Ready? Let's do this. So, the first step to making your movie is the development stage, which really revolves all around the script. What makes a good screenplay, especially for a short film? One of the most important things that I've learned making my own movies with barely any budget at all is write to your means. And so I looked around and I said, okay, I have access to my house, mom's house, dad's house, family's house, you know, friend's house. I have access to this public park. You know what I mean? Rack your brain and think of the places and the locations that you have access to and write around that. Think about the people that you know. Do you have actors that can be in your movie? What equipment do you have? Do you have a phone? Do you have a camera? Do you have a microphone? When it comes to making your own movie, think small. Scale down your story and don't go so big right off the bat, because small stories can still be great. The most important thing is the story itself. So really what you want to focus on is having a beginning, a middle, and an end, and giving your character an arc of some type, having them grow or learn or change in some way from the beginning point of the film to the end, and that can be achieved in a 30-second film as well as a 90-minute film. Another thing to keep in mind is that when you're first starting out, you don't necessarily need a fancy screenwriting software. If you're younger and you just don't have those resources available to you yet, just keep that in mind, that it doesn't need to be super professional right off the bat. Fake it till you make it. Preparation is key in filmmaking. And once you have your script written, rewritten, rewritten again, and ready to go, ready to film, it's time to move on to the budget and figuring out what money you have. Do you have any money at all? Look at your savings account. Or are you in a position where you need to look elsewhere? The next place I would suggest looking is family. Do you have family that would want to become producers and invest a little cash in your next idea? So one of the strategies that I used on my own films was to use crowdfunding websites like Kickstarter and Indiegogo. It helped me to fundraise a good amount of money. For my feature film Bound, I was able to raise over $2,000 using online fundraising, and that's just money that came from generous supporters who were excited about seeing this movie come to light. But if you create something simplified and you create something where the costumes are things you already have in your home, the props, the sets are things you have at your disposal, that's gonna make things cheaper and more manageable and easier, especially when you're making a movie by yourself. Once you've determined your budget, you have to look at your location. So this all kind of goes hand in hand. You may have already figured out some of your locations because you were writing to your means. But if you haven't necessarily figured those those out, now is the time to lock down those locations. And I would suggest getting those things in writing. If you're going to someone's house, I would suggest typing something up and just making sure that they agree to the dates and that they're aware of what you're doing in their home. Now, it's a little bit different if it's family, if it's like your parents' house and you do that all the time. Like, obviously, there's levels of comfortability with different people. Another thing with locations, especially when you are doing it yourself, is to try to keep them to a minimum. If you can swing it, try to write an entire movie that takes place in one room. I'm not even joking, because the more that you have to pick up your equipment and move it to a new setup and do all of what goes into that, it's gonna take you so much longer when you're by yourself. That's the whole thing here, is we're working without a crew, right? So when it's just you by yourself, the efficiency goes way down. And so you sort of have to account for that when you're in the planning stages and set yourself up for success by not giving yourself an abundance of locations and setups and different angles where you have to move the equipment over and over and over. And one scene could take you several hours to complete. So definitely keep that in mind. Scheduling your film can be one of the trickiest parts of the entire process. You need to do something called breaking down your script. So you need to go through your script and pretty much separate everything in your whole script into different categories. So you're gonna list out all of the props, all of the costumes, all of the actors, all of the locations. Anything that's involved in your movie in any capacity needs to be broken down. And in future videos, I'll expand on breaking down the script and lining the script and scheduling way, way more, because it's so expansive. So I really, really want to like go more in depth on that. But once you have everything categorized and it all makes sense, you're able to figure out your shoot schedule. So you really want to shoot around location. If you didn't know, most movies are shot out of order. They're not shot in chronological order from beginning to end. And that's because the most efficient way to shoot multiple scenes in multiple locations is to condense them down. You want to put everything together so that you're only visiting that location for one day or however long you need to be at that location. It's all in one condensed section of time, as opposed to having to return to that location over and over to film different scenes. That just doesn't make sense. It's just not efficient. Another thing to consider is flexibility. So you could create this perfect schedule. Believe me, I've done it. And then you involve actors or external people, and that's when things just don't work out. Everyone has different availability. Everyone has different time that they can give, and it's really hard to sort of match everybody up on the same schedule and get everyone together for a specific period of time. So just keep that in mind, that when you're on a small scale like this and you're doing it all yourself, you do have to stay flexible. All right, so we have our script, we have our budget, and we have our locations. Now it's time to audition our actors. Now, again, if we're doing this on our own and we truly want to do it on our own, we don't need to worry about auditioning actors, right? Because we're doing it ourselves. So we are the actor, we're the star. Or maybe it's you and one other person. You could potentially use a friend that you trust, but I would advise against that if you're serious. Now, if you're just doing something for fun with your friends, that's completely different. You can do things with your friends, involve your friends, but if you do write a story that just can't be told without a few actors, here's my advice. Try to find local theater students. Look for people who are building their resume and that understand that what you're creating is a passion project. Casting is really, really important when it comes to a movie. If you have a friend that 100% matches the description of one of your characters, then yeah, that makes sense to take a chance on them. But if you're just choosing someone because it's the only person that you have access to, I challenge you to not rush it. To wait until you do find the right person for the job. Or don't write a screenplay that requires more than just yourself in a role. Your film will suffer if you don't have the right actors in the role. And that's not to say that an amateur actor can't do an excellent job, because they totally can, but you need to find them. You need to audition them and find them, and not just hand the role to a friend because they think that what you're doing is kind of cool, but then they get to set and realize, oh, this is 10 hours of really hard work where I can't really talk or be on my phone. And people kind of realize really quickly that being on set is not at all the glamorous vision that they might have had in their mind. That's what's happened to me in the past, where someone has offered to help without fully realizing what their offer truly means. And I think that's what you need to do, is if you are involving a friend, is you really need to drive home the importance of your project and what it means to you, and let them know that this is not just some fun hobby that you're doing to pass the time. This is your career, this is your future. So take it seriously. Now, after you've found any actors that you may or may not be using in your film, it's time to find your crew. And I know, I said that this video is all about just you, no crew. But the process of making a movie on your own and making a movie with one or two people in your crew is honestly pretty similar. The amount of jobs that you're all doing is still extremely high for a normal set, and the pressure is still really on. It's really still all on you. You just have a little bit of help instead of no help at all. So try to get at least like one or two people to help you that are dedicated and kind of know what they're doing if possible. But if you don't have access to any people and it is all on you, you can still do this. You just might need some stands and clamps and a little more patience than you normally would. When you're doing things on your own, you won't be quite as efficient as if you had a full crew. But with determination and a clear vision, you are capable of doing anything you set your mind to, no matter your age or your gender. Moving right along to the equipment or the gear that you are using. So this is really honestly not as important as I used to think it was. When I was a kid, I put so much stock in having the best quality gear possible. I wanted the best camera. I wanted the best microphone. I wanted the best tripod. And as you can see, I have spent the past 10, 15 years collecting gear. That's really what it comes down to, is what do you have access to? Do you have a camera? If you're younger, do your parents have a camera? I bet you do have a phone that has a camera, that has a pretty good camera, especially these newer phones. Whether it's Apple or Samsung, we have amazing cameras in our phones that can easily be used to create beautiful shots. When it comes to gear, I think that the thing you really want to focus on is your audio. So if all you have is an iPhone and your house lamps for camera and lighting, at least invest in a microphone. And when I say invest, I don't mean invest hundreds of dollars. But if you really want to make a movie, then that's one of the things that you need to add to your budget. You need to include that in your budget and know that, hey, I need to at least invest this much in good quality audio. It's pretty well known that audiences will forgive poor quality video, but they will not forgive poor quality audio. So when it comes to production design, this is another place where you want to go to your friends and family and see what you have access to before you spend any money. And then once you know what you have and what you still need, I would suggest going to thrift stores. Thrift stores are your best friend in this scenario. I would also suggest checking out garage sales and yard sales and estate sales. These are all wonderful places where you could find unique items that are really, really affordable for your next movie. For my film Bound, we went as far as to create sets in my living room. We used chicken wire and paper mache to create the walls of a cave, and so we went really, really big. In that instance, I had a lot of hands helping me. I had experts who knew what they were doing in those areas helping me. So I would not suggest doing that if you are working by yourself. Now, if you can pull that stuff off by yourself, have at it. That's awesome, first of all. I'm jealous. But if you're like me and that's a little bit too ambitious for one person, then try to keep your sets small. We've prepared, and we have prepared some more. And now it's time to shoot. It's time to film this movie. We are on set and we are ready to go. So, how are we pulling this off without a crew? Simplicity is key in this scenario because you don't want to overcomplicate the situation. It's already going to be taking longer for you because you're by yourself. Only plan for shots and things that you can achieve on your own simply and easily. But that doesn't mean that you want to take the safe route. You still want to leave yourself freedom to experiment and to play with different shots. So keep a variety of shots, but just be mindful of the types of shots that you're planning. An easy way to learn is to just watch movies. Make sure you are storyboarding. This is a huge, huge thing. If you storyboard it out and you give a visual representation of every single shot and what you want, it's really gonna help you, not just on set, but later on in editing. It's gonna keep you organized and it's gonna keep you moving. When it comes to a storyboard, you don't have to be an artist. I'm certainly not. But you are the only one that needs to know what's happening on your storyboard, especially if you are making this movie by yourself. It's something that you're creating and no one needs to understand your drawing, but you could literally use stick figures if you want. Just put the image onto paper. So you want to make sure that you rehearse. It doesn't have to be as extensive as a theater rehearsal, but you do want to rehearse with whatever actors you're using, and you want to rehearse with your equipment. So if you have a specific shot that requires movement in accordance with an actor speaking a line, you want to go through that blocking, do at least one run through of each scene so that you know the mechanics of how you'll be moving, and you won't be tripping over things or bumping into the actor. It'll just move seamlessly, and end as though it's like a rehearsed dance. Make sure your scenes are lit well. One of the easiest ways to do this is to use natural light if you can. So try to write your script where most of your scenes take place during the day. I know that sounds silly, but it is a really easy way to not have to deal with low light. Low light can be really tricky, especially when you're new and you're starting out and you don't know how to deal with color correction and color grading and fixing those things in post. You always want to make your movie thinking of yourself in the editing room. You want to help yourself out and make the job in the editing room as easy as possible. Audio. This is probably the most important part of production. Like I said before, audiences are quicker to forgive poor video quality as opposed to poor audio quality. We need to be able to hear what's going on, and it needs to be clear. It needs to blend well, it needs to be seamless, and we need to take certain things into consideration. Little things like turning off the AC, making sure to shoot wild sound while you're on set, so footsteps, turning on a faucet, opening a door, these are all sound effects that you would create in Foley and post, but if you capture the wild sound on set, you're saving yourself that trouble later on. A couple options for capturing audio in production. So right now I have my microphone attached to the top of my camera. It's mounted on my camera and it's plugged into my camera. However, it is limiting. So you're only really able to use this setup when the actor is in close proximity to the camera. Once your actor is 5-6 feet away or more, you're going to want to mount a shotgun mic onto a mic stand and suspend it in some way near your actors. And the very last tip that I have is really, really important. It's an organizational tip and it's kind of a logistical tip. So basically you want to have a binder, like a master binder for your film. You're going to have all of the details for your movie in this binder, but specifically you want to bring it to set, and when you have it on set, inside it's going to have the script, the storyboard, the breakdowns, as well as your shot list. And while you're making your film, if anything of note happens, write it down. Take those notes, again, helping yourself out later on in editing. This is a way that you can stay organized and keep continuity and stay on task and make sure that everything is consistent and makes sense in your movie. Hair and makeup. Again, when you're by yourself, you don't want to do anything crazy elaborate unless you are well-versed in special effects makeup and your script calls for that. Write to what you know how to do. If you don't know how to make prosthetic fingers or fake blood or wounds on your face, then don't write that into your script. That doesn't make any sense. So just think about that. Think about your own abilities. If you can only do basic makeup, then make sure that your character only requires basic makeup. But if you like to have fun with special effects makeup and it's something that you're good at, then go ahead and have fun with it. Why not? So consider all of that. Think about the time period. Think about all of these different factors as well as your own abilities when you're planning out your hair and makeup. So craft services. And I know that might sound silly if you are making a movie by yourself, but staying hydrated and staying well fed while you're working on set is so important, especially if you're by yourself and you are the only one doing everything and moving the heavy equipment and on your feet the whole time and the adrenaline's pumping. Create a schedule for yourself where you take frequent water breaks, where you feed yourself, whether it's snacks, or if you do know that you're gonna have a day where it's hours of shooting, set yourself a time for lunch. Don't just think, oh, I'm by myself, so I'll eat when I eat, because you might not. You might get really, really into the work that you're doing and you might forget. And this is equally important when you do have other people on your set. So if you are working with, whether it's one or two or more actors, make sure that they are well fed, especially if you are not able to pay them at this point in your career. So if you're just starting out and we're all coming together and we're making this passion project, one of the best things that you can do is make sure that your dedicated cast and potential crew are well fed and well hydrated. This is so, so important. Take care of yourself, because you're the one making the movie and these long hours require you to be in tip-top shape, and you will not be in tip-top shape if you are not properly fueling yourself. So we've just finished shooting our movie and the next step is post-production, and it's all about editing. Whether you're using iMovie, Final Cut Pro, or Adobe, the most important thing to remember when it comes to editing is to stay organized, especially when you're working on your own. Another thing, you're going to need storage. Now, if you're working on films that are between 30 seconds and 5 minutes, you won't need quite as much storage as if you're working on something that's 20 minutes or longer. But you still want to have a good quality hard drive that you can work off of so that you're not editing on your computer. And what I mean there is when you're taking the files off of your card, instead of saving those files on your computer, you save them on an external hard drive and then edit in your editing program off of that external hard drive so that you're not involving your main computer's hard drive in any of that work. That's gonna keep your computer clear throughout your editing process. It's gonna make things go by faster. Try to learn the basics if you can. You definitely don't need to know fancy, advanced techniques to make a movie. You can do things by keeping it simple, and sometimes keeping it simple is the better option. And you definitely don't need one of those advanced programs right off the bat. If you're just starting out and you're just learning how to edit, you can do this on iMovie or whatever program comes with the computer that you have. You can even get iMovie on your phone. It doesn't have nearly as many options on your phone. You're definitely limited when it comes to editing on your phone, but it can be done. So if you don't have access to a computer, you're not in the dark. You can still do this. You can still make your own movie. One part of editing is digital effects. So this is something that you should not mess with unless you know how. I do not. So that's why I don't put digital effects in my films for the most part. I kind of tried to mess around with it with my feature film Bound, and it was really, really bad. It did not look good. So unless you know someone who is versed in digital effects and CGI and all of that, when it comes to making your own movie on your own, I would suggest staying away from digital effects. And the final step in post-production is post audio and music. So if you captured proper audio for your film, you're gonna have multiple tracks that you're going to be working with on your editing timeline. So you're gonna have a different track for the dialogue, for the sound effects, for the ambient sound, for the music, for the Foley, for any little different sound is gonna have its own track. That way you can individually adjust each track to have the sounds blend together seamlessly. That's called sound mixing. When it comes to music, you have to be really careful here. You don't wanna use something that is copyrighted. So there's a couple options here, and I've actually explored a few of them. And one of them is to purchase stock music. There's different websites that you can use. I've actually used Triune Scores from Film Jams. Another option is to find a composer. So just like we're looking for actors who potentially want to build up their resume and build their career, you want to do the same for a composer. A lot of up-and-coming composers would love the chance to have their music featured in someone's film, something that can be seen by hundreds, if not thousands, of people, and it's, again, mutually beneficial to everyone involved. All right, so we have a finished movie. We have planned it, we've filmed it, we've edited it, and we've done it all on our own. Well, what do we do now? There are lots of options for the future of your short film. You can choose to do lots of different things with it. One of the most common routes you could take is the festival route. There are short film festivals all over the country that you don't even need to attend to enter. Lots of these festivals you can enter online and potentially win accolades for your film that way. Now you might be thinking, whoa, I just made this tiny little movie all by myself. I'm not ready to put it into festivals, and I'm definitely not ready to sell it. Well, don't worry, because there is another level where you can just release it online. Just like this, I have a YouTube channel. I could release my film here. You could start a YouTube channel and release your films online. You could promote them through your personal website. Any way to try to garner some attention and get people to watch your movie. At this point, once you have a finished movie, it's really up to you what you want to do with it. If film is something that you truly want to pursue, you don't necessarily have to enter it into festivals, but you do need to learn from it and grow from it. And you need to use it as your stepping stone to then go on and make your next movie. But at this point, while you're still making your own movie all by yourself, I would suggest getting that film out to as many people as possible. Friends, family, strangers, get people to watch your movie, give you feedback, and then just start writing. Start brainstorming. Start coming up with your next big idea. I have been so focused for the last 2 years on our wedding that I haven't really been able to make any movies. And it's how I express myself creatively. And when I don't have that outlet, it really is detrimental to my mental health. So for that reason, and because of this series, I have decided that I am going to make my own movie by myself in accordance with this series. So as we go along week to week and I show you how to make your own movie, I will also be making my own movie and showing you in real time, step by step, how you can actually do it. And then at the end of the series, I will have my own movie that I have just created by myself. And hopefully you want to join me on that journey. I challenge you, if you are sitting at home and you have any interest in film at all, you've ever wanted to make a movie, even just an idea in the back of your brain, I challenge you, even if it's 30 seconds long, to make a movie with me. Let's do this together and go on this journey and create something awesome. So if you are up for the challenge, comment down below and let me know. Thank you so much for watching today's video. I am so excited to continue this series and make my own movie, and hopefully some of you will join me and make your own movies. And if you've already made a movie of your own, whether it's a short or feature, go ahead and link that down below. I'd love to be able to watch your movies and support you as well. And that brings us to something new that I'm actually gonna be starting at the end of each of my videos. So I really wanna do some type of charity shout out. Right now I'm calling it Cause of the Month, and I'm gonna choose a different charity for every single month. And essentially I'll promote that charity at the end of each of my videos, and I'll have links in my description box where you guys can scroll down and click and learn more about the charity and find out how you can help and support, whether it's monetarily or just spreading the word and awareness. Don't forget to give this video a like if you liked it, and subscribe to my channel so you won't miss one video in this upcoming series all about making your own movie, just you, no crew. I hope you have a great day or night wherever you are, and I will see you in the next one. All right, bye guys. Every time I try to film, I hear screaming children outside. Ooh, oh. This chair is squeaky!